I ran out of cuticle oil, and I have to make another one. So I thought, why not just do it on video? So that's what I'm doing. If you're interested, keep watching. My cuticle oil is very simple. I use 2 or 3 products only. One of the ingredients that I use is coconut oil. This is a very popular brand for coconut oil. Where did I get this? I got this at Whole Foods for about maybe $13. I don't quite remember. Yeah, so it's coconut oil. I use vitamin E oil. I don't remember where I bought this, but I will try to, I will look it up and then, you know, leave it in the description if anybody's interested. It's really, really good. It is 100% coconut oil and it is odorless. So if you don't like scents on the products that you wear, this, you can still wear this because it's completely odorless. And then I use extra virgin olive oil. I think I got this from Target for about, it's not expensive, okay? So yeah, that's all I use as far as the oils go. And then I like for my oils to have a certain aroma. And I use rosemary oil mostly for my cuticle oil. Let's see if this thing will focus. I also bought this at Whole Foods, but I think you can get this at Walgreens and some other stores. I don't think it's going to focus. Okay, there it is. You can see this is what the bottle looks like. See it. Anyway, it's called the Auracacia Rosemary Activating Oil. It says 100% pure essential oils and it smells amazingly. So I add a couple of drops of this to my oil just to make it smell nice. I don't know that it does anything for nails. I don't know. But I like the way it smells. So, this is how I make it. I just pour them basically in whatever proportions that you want. Just pour them into the bottle. I should have brought a paper towel or something so that I don't spill stuff all over. Whatever. Okay, so. The good thing about making this yourself is that you control the proportions of, you know, oils, that which oil is in your cuticle oil. You know what I mean? Like, if you've seen my what's the video titled? I only have like 2 videos, so I don't know why I'm forgetting the title of it. I think I titled it, How to Stop Peeling Nails. I made a video on how to stop peeling nails, and I talked about how when you purchase cuticle oil, it would say, you know, maybe olive oil and vitamin E oil, but there's only this much vitamin E oil and this much olive oil, and you think you're getting 50-50, but they don't say that. Yeah. So it's best to make your own oil, and that's what I do. It's really easy. I mean, you're basically just decanting one oil into another bottle. That's it. And mixing up. Use whatever oil that you want. You know. So I'm gonna add the olive oil now. Olive oil is pretty yellow. So that's gonna be all for the olive oil. Actually, I'll add a little bit more olive oil because this is not much at all. Olive oil is the least expensive of all the oils I have here, so I'm not so concerned about, you know, using a lot of it. The coconut oil is quite expensive. And next, this is how much oil I have. Just sit this on something so you can see. I set this in my cookie box. Yeah. This is, I was eating this earlier. It's like, it's cookies. It's delicious. Okay, I'm gonna add the vitamin E oil. Oh my god, look at how full this is. When you purchase this, it is really, really, really full. See that? You can see it's filled to the brim. It's really full. It's good. Wow. I did not know it was this thick. See that? It's like castor oil. The thickness, I mean. It's 100% vitamin E oil. You know, I don't want to waste this oil. I had to go online to find 100% vitamin E oil because I could not find it anywhere. I looked in health food stores, I looked in, you know, regular department stores, grocery stores. I couldn't find it. But I'm glad I did. I really like this. It's so thick. It smells mostly of olive oil. Olive oil has a very distinctive aroma and it's quite strong, but I don't like the smell of it, so I'm gonna mask it with the rosemary oil. I just wish this thing would focus so easily. Okay, it's focusing now. That's what the bottle looks like. I see this everywhere with, you know, I see a lot of people use this, so it's a pretty popular company. It should be easy to find if you want this. So I will add rosemary oil is a pretty strong scent. I mean, the essential oil. So I'll only add a few drops of it and see if I like the way it smells. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Oof, 6. Too much, but see, because the olive oil has a very strong odor in it. I'm trying to mask that. It is not too strong. It's perfect, actually, and I like it. Nice. When I apply cuticle oil, I don't wash them off my hands. I leave them on and then I sort of rub them in and then apply my nail polish on top of it. It does not cause the polish to peel off at all. If you don't add too much, it will be fine. And since I don't rinse off my since I don't rinse off my cuticle oils, I like for it to have a nice scent. Okay. I wouldn't care about the scent so much if, you know, I would wash my hands after applying them, but I don't wash my hands. So I like for it to smell nice. And there you go. That is my cuticle oil. Very, very simple. I have one tip as far as using coconut oil though. When you use extra virgin coconut oil, it solidifies when the temperature is cool. So in summer or when the weather's warm, you can have it, you can mix it with your other oils and you can have it, you know, remain in liquid form. But when you mix coconut oil with your other oils in winter, it might not stay liquid. I don't know. I've never tried it. I've been scared of adding coconut oil to my other oils because when it's cold, because I think that, you know, it will solidify and I would have to heat it up, you know, in my hands first before being able to use it, and you don't always have that kind of time. So yeah, this is my cuticle oil. I love it. It works wonders for me. My nails look so much better now than they used to look before. I'm still growing them out. This one is a bit long. I have to cut it off, trim it a little bit so that it's, you know, about the same length as the other ones. They're all not equal length right now. Let's see if I can show it. But that's because I'm trying to grow them out. I don't like short nails. I have to grow my nails out. I'm glad that I work at a place where I wear gloves the majority of the time, so nobody can see my nails. So I love it. I love that. So I can have long nails. You can have whatever nail design you want at my job and nobody cares because you're wearing gloves. So yeah, this is my cuticle oil. I might do a giveaway of this someday, but I feel as though it's such a common thing and everybody who wants them knows how to make them, so it might be, you know, redundant. But if anybody wants a giveaway, just let me know and I will, you know, set one up and send one out to somebody. Okay, thank you for watching. Rate, comment, subscribe, and I will see you in my other video. Bye. Written down on my phone, so I'll be looking down. Okay. Now I use vitamin E because it heals any damage to the cuticles. It also prevents the loss of water. Vitamin E is a thick oil. Okay, 100% vitamin E is thick, and when you apply it to your nails, it covers the skin of your cuticles, and because it's so thick, it does a very good job of covering the skin and preventing the evaporation of water or whatever little moisture that you have left in your nails. That way your nails stay moisturized longer. And since it's an oil, it also lubricates your cuticles so they don't dry out. And I use olive oil because they also prevent over drying. And olive oil increases the flexibility of the nail. The thing with inflexible nails is that when your nails are very rigid and not flexible, when you hit them on something, you don't even have to hit them really hard for it to break off. But if you have flexible nails, they bend more easily. Now, you don't want them bending too much, but you want them to have some ability to bend. And that's what olive oil does. It makes the nails more flexible so that when you hit it on something, it can bend and not break instantly. Okay. And then I use coconut oil because it also heals the cuticles and it moisturizes, and it has antifungal properties. Prevention is better than cure. So I don't have nail fungus, but you know, I don't have to wait until I get nail fungus in order to prevent it, you know. So I use coconut oil because of those three reasons. And I also wanted to say that if you have a specific problem with your nails, let's say you have some bacterial problems or fungal problems or, you know, whatever problems, there are oils out there that fight these things, okay? So there are oils such as coconut oil that has antifungal properties, just in case you touch something, you know, and you increase your chance of getting fungus, coconut oil will combat that. There are also oils that have antibacterial properties. It won't kill all the bacteria in your nails, because that's not possible, but it will prevent some harmful bacteria from infecting your nails, especially if you have long nails. You know, you have to be very careful of that. So yeah, that is why I use these three oils, and they work perfectly for me. I will insert a clip of what my nails used to look like before I started making my own oils and really taking care of my nails. They were really, really, really bad. They were peeling really badly. The surface of the nail would peel off, and then the nail becomes so thin that it breaks off. And you will see the difference between what my nails used to look like and what they look like now. So I would really encourage you to make your own oil. That way it has what you want to be in it. It has, if you're allergic to, I don't know, something in an oil, you don't have to put it in it. You know exactly what's, you know, in your cuticle oil. So